Hi, I'm John Papa. Let's create a Node application that talks to Azure's Cosmos DB using the new SQL API, following the quick start here. You can use this link to follow these steps. I'm going to start by creating my own directory here. I call it a Cosmos SQL API quick start, and then I'm going to navigate inside of it. Then I'm going to refresh my instance of Visual Studio Code, so it's pointing at the folder that I just went to. Next, I'm going to open up the terminal and I'm going to clear it out and I'm going to go to the Azure extensions here where you can see I have a few extensions and the one we're going to play with is Cosmos DB. I'm going to right click and create an account. And I'll name my account Cosmos SQL API Quick Start, choose SQL and create a new resource group. Now you pick the names that you want. I like to prefix mine with my name, so I'm going to do that right here. Then I'm going to choose a location that's closest to me. All this is following the Quick Start. Then you'll see that it's creating the Cosmos DB. This will create somewhere between, 1 to 3 minutes. So in the meantime, I'm gonna go ahead and create a new file called app.js and then another file called config.js. These are down inside of the steps for setting up your Node application in the quick start. And then command J will get rid of the bottom bar and command B will get rid of the left sidebar. Now I'm gonna init a new package.json file. This will allow me to save any packages as dependencies right to this file. And as you might have guessed, the next step we're going to do is install a package. This is going to be the Azure Cosmos package. This is so we can interact with the SDK to talk to Cosmos DB from our Node application. Now we'll go back and take a look and we can see that our Cosmos DB is ready. So now we're going to go ahead and enter the endpoint and primary key. Now here's a trick. You can copy the connection string into your file and paste it. Now this is your secure information. So notice that you're seeing here my URL to my database and then my account key. It's like a password. I'm going to put the endpoint in here and then I'm going to put my primary key up here inside config.primary key. Notice these will be disappeared by the time you try this, so don't try mine. And of course, don't share yours. Then I'm going to copy the next steps. This is basically all the data that the quick start asks you to enter in. It's some sample data for a family. Next, we're going to export this module called config. Now we're going to go over to the app.js file and we're going to import the Cosmos client from the library. Then we're going to import the configuration. We're going to set up our client to talk to it. We'll identify the database and the container ID. The database is going to be our database. The container is like a table. And then we're going to set up some exit functionality so we can go ahead and press any key to exit out of here. It's just some basic housekeeping. And then finally, we've got the create database command at the bottom. Now this is the key code. This kicks everything off for us. Now once we have this, we can run it down to our terminal by typing node app.js. And then we'll see the output. We created the database and we read the database. Now there's nothing in it yet. So the next step talks about how we put something in it. Now notice over here in the tools, we can see in the sidebar, there is nothing but a family database. Next, we're going to create a container. Now, once we have the container, we'll use the create container and then we'll use read container to read it. And then down below in our kickoff code, we'll put in there create container, read container. Again, this comes out of the quick start. We run it and we can see we create the database, the container, and then we're reading the container. So if we go back to the Azure tools, this time inside of the family database, once we refresh, you'll see a family container and there are no documents in it yet. Documents are our data. So the next step is we can go ahead and create an item. Again, right from the quick start, we're going to create a family item. It's going to read the data out of config.js. And then once we have that function, we'll paste that down underneath the read container. We'll create two family items. So now, once we have a container, we're inserting Anderson 1 and Wakefield 7. Again, we go back and look at our documents. We refresh inside the Cosmos DB VS Code extension, and we can see those right here. All right, so if we keep moving along, once we have that data, what else can we do? Well, we can actually query our Cosmos DB resources. This is a cool part. So even though it's a Mongo database or Document DB, we can actually write a query with it using different languages like SQL. So we paste that code in. Now we can see that we've queried that particular character. What about updating items? Well, we can replace items too. So that's the next step in the quick start. We're going to replace an item using this function here. It's going to find this item and change the grade from, I believe, 5 to 6. We'll paste that down here under query container to replace the item and query it again. So now we can see that we create the container and it's got grade 6 right there. And last, let's go ahead and delete an item. This is also right from the quick start. Here's some simple code to delete an item in the container. And then we'll put that code right underneath query container. It's going to delete the family item called Anderson. We'll run the Node app. And at the bottom, you can see that we deleted that item. And of course, you can go query this in the Azure tools to check it out. I encourage you to try everything that you see right here from the quick start. And if you'd like any help, you can find me up on Twitter @John_Papa. Thanks for watching.